Today we'll discuss about operators in MongoDB. In the last class, we have discussed how to work with Visual Studio 3T, how to create the basic queries like creating the collection, inserting the data in the collection. So MongoDB supports different types of operators. What is the purpose of these operators? We already know the data will be stored in the database in the form of documents. Is it clear? Collection database is conserve group of collections, collection in conserve group of documents, and in MongoDB the data will be stored in the form of key and value pair format. Is it clear? Key and value pair format. And if you want to fetch the data from the database, if you want to fetch the data from the collections, we have to write some queries. Generally we'll call as CRUD operations: insert, update, delete and select. R means retrieve. So if you want, mostly when we perform any operation, mostly we'll work with select operation, select command, because we need to fetch the data from the collection documents and display in the front end. So at the time of writing this select command, we'll use these operators and all the other concepts. We need to filter the data. Generally, if you want to filter the data before displaying the output in the front end, we'll use this select command. So there are different types of operators are there, like comparison operators, logical operators, element operators, evaluation operators, geospatial operators, projection operators. Here actually it is somewhat different comparing with your RDBMS operators. Is it clear? And the syntax is also different, and the working environment is also different actually, working with these operators. So today we'll discuss about how to work with these operators. Comparison operators are here: equal operator, greater than operator, greater than or equal operator, in operator, less than operator, less than or equal operator, not equal operator, not in operator. The representation of the operator is dollar. EQ means equal operator. GT means greater. GTE means greater than or equal. In operator, less than operator, less than or equal, not in. Similarly, logical operators are end operator, not operator, nor operator, or operator. Element operators: exists operator, type operator. Evaluation operator: expression operator, JSON schema, modulus operator, regular expression operator, text operator, where operator. Geospatial operators: geo intersects operator, geo within operator, near operator, near sphere operator. Array: in order to perform any operations on arrays, you have some special operators: all operator, element match operator, size operator. Some abbreviations you must have the knowledge, you must not confuse. Here there are no symbols like your other languages, like less than, greater than, less than or equal, greater than or equal, double equal, not equal. Like we are habituated, any SQL background developers, maybe mostly Oracle or SQL Server developers, they're MySQL, they're comfortable with these operators. But here some different operators are available. We must know how to work with that. Is it clear? EQ means equal operator. Our main target is to fetch the data from the collection. So first of all, I will open my command prompt and I will try to type the command MongoD so that my server will be started. Already I started the server and I am trying to open my Studio 3T. Is it clear? Here you can connect to the database. Click on connect, testing the connection, and then here you can go to IntelliShell. Here we can write the queries. Before that, I want to create some collection actually, so that I want to write some queries. So here I want to create one database, use EMPs. My database name I'll give as EMPs execute. If the database is not there, the database will be created. Yes or no? And then I want to create the collection. How to create the collection? DB dot create collection. There is one predefined function is that DB dot create collection of collection name I will try to give. The name of the collection I'll give as EMP. Here I'll try to create one collection. Select the query, here execute. Now my collection is created. Now I want to insert the record in the collection. how to insert db dot collection name emp dot, there is one predefined function called insert. I want to insert the data in the form of key and value pair format. Here I'll try to give something like e number colon some value. Key is variable name, column name, value is the column value. And here I'll try to give something like e name colon. Here I'll try to give some value. So Anil I will try to give. And again I'll try to give key salary colon. Here I'll try to give 20,000. Some salary I'll try to give. Is it clear? And here I'll try to give one more column called years. Key I will give as years, colon, value I'll try to give as 20. Is it clear? So I want to maintain the data in the form of key and value pair format. Yes or no? So here you can select the query, press F5 or execute the query F9. Here you can see. Okay, anyway, if you want to see the data, what is the query? Find method db dot collection name emp dot find of. It is used to find the data from the collection. Execute. I think I inserted three times. If you want, you can edit here. GUI nature is given here. Just you can delete. Here only you can do editing. If you want to update the data, here only you can update something like Anil Kumar. Something like this. Here only you can update if you want. Automatically the changes will be saved. So I want to insert one more record. Copy this one. 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 records I'll try to insert. Here I'll try to go 102, 103, 104, 105. We can write the queries in two ways. One is through GUI. One is manual query also you can write. Anil, Sunil. Here I'll try to give Ajay. And here I'll try to give some Ram. And here I'll try to give some Robert. And some salaries also will change, some 30,000, some 25,000, here some 32,000. Here I'll try to give the years some 25, here some 30, here some 22, something like this. So select the all the queries which you want to execute. Execute, press F9. Now once again run this command, db.emp.find. So you can see the data that is available in the collections. Documents you can see. Is it clear? So here also you can see the explorer, right click, refresh all. You can see the newly created database, EMPs is available. You can open that. There you can see your collection. There you can see the documents. One collection is available. Is it clear? Okay, how to work with GUI, we will see that one later. Are you following? So initially we have created one collection and we have inserted the documents in that collection. Now, in order to fetch the data from the collection, we have to write some queries. In order to fetch the data from the collection, we can write some what? Queries. This is what I have done until now. It is used to fetch the data. So, I want to use some operators. For that, I want to write some queries. So, here, first of all, we must have the knowledge on comparison operator. What is the use of comparison operator? Comparison operators means what? These are the comparison operator. One is equal operator. Matches values that are equal to the specific value. Greater than operator. GT means greater than. GTE means greater than or equal. Dollar in. This is in operator. This is less than operator. LT. LT means less than operator. LTE means less than or equal operator. NE means not equal operator. NIN means not in operator. These all are different types of what? Operators that are available. So whenever you want to work with these operators, you have to attach this value. So if you want to fetch the data, for example, I want to display the employee details whose salary is greater than 20,000, or I want to display the employee details whose salary is equal to 20,000, like that. Is it clear? So let us see how to write the queries by using this comparison operator. Did you understood? Try to habituate for this syntax, all of you. Is it clear? Basic queries we will try to learn first. And here I'll try to write one more query. If you want to display the employee details whose salary is greater than or equal to 30,000, some query I will try to write. Write a query to display the employee details whose salary is greater than or equal to 30,000. So what is the symbol you have to use? GTE symbol you have to use. Same query I'll try to copy and I'll try to paste it here. GTE means greater than or equal to 30,000, something like this. Select the query, execute the query. You'll get the employee details whose salary is greater than or equal to 30,000, 30 and 32,000. Like that, you can write the basic commands. Basic queries you can write here. Let us say I'll show you some queries here. Same queries what I written. Is it clear? Fetch the employee details whose salary is equal to 20,000. Fetch the employee details whose age is equal to 20. Fetch the employee details whose salary is greater than 20,000. Fetch the employee details whose salary is greater than or equal to 30,000. Fetch the employee details whose salary is less than or equal to 30,000. Like this, you can write the basic queries by using these comparison operators. So here, this is about the basic operators what we discussed. These operators, comparison operators, equal, greater, greater than or equal, and in operator. In operator and not in operator. In operator means if you want to retrieve the data within the given range, then you can use this in operator. If you want to retrieve the data within the given range, then you can use in operator. Means some group of values will be there. Collection is nothing but group of documents. No? In that group of documents, if you want to fetch the data, we can use in operator. Let us see here, I'll show you. So I want to display all the employee details. Use this find method. So all the employees 101, 102, 105, all employees came. So I want to use, it is used to search the data from the collection based on the given input. It will also similar like OR operator, in operator. So db dot collection name emp dot, here I will try to use find method, find of, here I will try to give some expression, something like, I want to display the employee details whose employee numbers are 101, 102, 103, 101, 102 and 107. So here I will try to give something like e number colon, and here I will try to apply the operator. Which operator I want to apply? In operator. So dollar in colon between the values 101, and here I'll try to give 102, and here I'll try to give 107, and here I'll try to give 109. So I want to, what is the meaning of this? I want to read the employee details whose employee number is 101, 102, 107 and 109. But there is no employee with name 107 and 109. So what in operator will do? It will fetch the data where the values are existing. 101, 102 only will come. 107, 109, it will neglect. Select and execute. Here you can see you'll get 101 and 102. In operator. Is it clear? Dollar in. If I try to write the same query with not in operator. Not in. N in operator. Not in is not there. N in. It will display the employee details which are not in 102, 102. 101, 102, 107, 109. Apart from 101 and 102, remaining will come. Execute. You'll get 103, 104 and 105. That is how you can work with in operator and not in operator. Okay. As an operator. Don't confuse. EQ means equal operator. GT means greater than. GTE means greater than or equal. IN means in operator, LT means less than operator, LTE means less than or equal operator, NE means not equal operator, NIN means not in operator, not in operator. Okay. Next we'll discuss about logical operators. These operators are used to compare two or more conditions and return only one value, either true or false. If you want to compare more than one condition and return only one value, then you have to use what? This AND operator and OR operator, logical operators. Condition 1 and condition 2. This is condition 1, this is condition 2. Here you have AND operator, here you have OR operator. Is it clear? So if condition 1 is true, it will compare two or more conditions and return a Boolean value. If both the conditions are true, AND operator will return true, OR also will return true. If either of the condition is true, true false, AND operator will return true, OR operator also will return true. Sorry, AND operator will return false. And here if I try to declare what? False and true. End operator will return false. Or operator will return true. And here if I declare both are false. End is false, or is false. End is false, or is false. Is it clear? So if you want to compare two or more conditions and return a boolean value, then you can use end operator and or operator. You can use and or. Okay, now let us see some queries here on end operator and or operator. So I want to display the employee details whose salary is equal to 20,000 and whose age is equal to 20. I want to display the employee details whose salary is equal to 20,000 and whose age is equal to 20. How to write? DB dot collection name emp dot find of. Here I'll try to use the operator. Which operator I want? End operator. Now here you have to mention the logical operator. End colon. Here you have to mention the expression. Expression inside the brackets. Here you have to mention the expression 1, comma, expression 2. In expression 1, you want to apply on which column? Salary. Salary colon. Here again you have to write dollar equal. I want to apply condition 1. Equal colon 20,000. So what is the meaning of that? Salary is equal to 20,000. And here I'll try to give age. Age colon. Here also I'll try to give equal. Age must be equal to 20. I want to display the employee details. This is expression 1. See here, don't confuse. Expression 1. Yes or no? This is expression 1. And this is expression 2. Is it clear? And we are applying the end operator. Generally in other languages, how we'll write salary greater than or salary is equal to 20,000. We'll write in other languages. And age is equal to 20. This is condition 1 and condition 2. But in MongoDB, we have to write in this manner. Okay, now by using logical operator, end operator. Let us see here once how it is working. Execute. It will display the employee details whose salary is equal to 20,000 and whose age is equal to 20. Anil and Sunil, both of the employees came. That is about end operator. And or operator. Write a query to display the employee details whose salary is equal to 20,000 or whose age is greater than 20. Greater than means GT. Execute. Whose age is equal will apply equal to 20. Execute. Same you got Anil and Sunil. Like this you can apply the conditions. We'll see one more operator called exists operator. Generally we already know in MongoDB the data will not be stored in the form of what? Schema. It will not maintain the schema. The data will be stored in the form of some documents format. For example, I have some data in this format. I'll try to give ID. ID colon. I'll try to write some data. ID colon, some ID I will give. So 1001. And here I'll try to give some name. I'll try to give some name also. Name colon. I'll try to give some name here. I'll try to give some Anil. And here I'll try to give some other column, something like registration number. I'll try to give registration number colon. Registration number colon, some 8989. Is it clear? And here I'll try to give some speed. Some speed colon. Some 25. I'll try to give something like this. Or some 40, 50. This is one document actually. It doesn't mean that every document must be in the same format. The data may change in one document to another document. Data will change and the field names also will change. Here I'll try to give 102. Here I'll give 3. Here I'll give 4. Something like that. And here I'll not give the name. I'll delete the name here. And here I'll try to delete the speed here in the another document. And I will keep the same document, something like this is my document I want to create. actually with these columns. So go to your database. Here I'll try to create one database. Use RegDB. RegDB. I'll try to create one database. Execute. And I want to create one collection. db.createCollection. Create collection of, here I'll try to give the name as reg. Reg. Select. Execute. And here I'll try to fetch, insert the data in the document. Is it clear? So here I'll try to write something like this. How to write? db dot collection name, reg dot db dot reg dot insert of db dot reg dot insert of, this is my document. I'll try to insert one document here. Execute. Okay. And similarly, I will try to copy this one. I want to insert all these documents. Is it clear? Select all these three commands. Execute. So now you can find the record. db.reg.findOf. db.reg.findOf. Execute. So you can see the records. See, but all the records are not existing. Now I want to check whether registration number is existing in the documents or not. I want to check whether registration number is existing or not. So for that you have an operator called exists operator. How to check means db.reg.findOf. db.reg.findOf. Here I'll try to write some field name. What is my field name I'll give? Registration number, reg number. Reg number colon. Here I'll try to write the operator. Dollar exists. Is it clear? Colon true. What is the meaning of this? I'm checking whether the registration number is existing in each document or not. It will return a boolean value, which will return either true or false. Once execute. Yes, registration number, all registration numbers came here. 1001, 0, I think I have not changed the numbers here. Okay. Now, for example, I will try to insert one more record. Here you see, without registration number. I'll try to delete the registration number here. Is it clear? Now I'll try to insert this command. Insert the record. And here again you can find the data. Execute. So here all the records, 104 also came here. Now when I try to execute this command, let us see. It must not display. 104 came again. I'll try to give 106 here. Same duplicate records I inserted. Execute. Okay, now here I will try to find the data. 106 is my record, which is not having the registration number. Is it clear? Select the query. Execute here. So 106 is there. Now find the registration numbers. Exist, I want to return that details only. If the condition is true, then the query will execute. It will fetch the data from the collection. So 104 came, 6 not came. If I try, I want to get the documents where the registration number does not exist, you can give false. So 104, 106 came. Is it clear? I think two times it was inserted, no? That is the problem. Anyway, no problem. 106 came. So that is about exists operator. If exists operator set to true, it will return the values where the condition became true. This operator returns only the documents which satisfy the condition. If the condition is true, it will return the documents. Otherwise, it will not return the documents. This is how you can work with these basic operators in our Mongo. Tomorrow we'll discuss about the other operators like evaluation operators, geospatial operators and array type operators. For more videos, try to subscribe to this channel, like, share and subscribe. Thank you. Have a nice day.